While everybody else is panic buying toilet paper and cleaning supplies and hand sanitizer and yeast and flour and baby food and dog food and everything at the grocery store, guess what I panic bought? Guess what I panic bought, yes everybody, okay. I panic bought some books from Bookoutlet and I'm gonna share them with you guys today. Hey everybody, it's Jessie and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I'm so happy you stopped by Jessie's shelf. This is the space where I talk about books, tea, and sometimes my dogs make an appearance, but not lately because I have locked myself into my spare room to film. So we're all on quarantine. The whole world is. We are here in Canada. And Sean's home, so I can't really take over the living room to film, so this is just how it's gonna go. I'm not a huge fan of the lighting in here, but we're making the best of it, and I'm taking some opportunity while I'm at home off work. I am essential, but when I'm off work, to film and kind of get my channel back to a normal state. So anyways, today is a book haul. So it's my panic buying book haul because Bookoutlet had a sale and it was 15% off everything. And then the pandemic hit and I thought, you know what? Fuck it. Fuck the book allowance. Let's just buy some books. So all these books are from Bookoutlet. I got them for pretty cheap and I'm going to show them to you guys. So the first book I want to talk to you guys about is The Hunting Party by Lucy Foley. Now, a few of my friends have read this and really enjoyed it. Lucy Foley also has a new book coming out in June, so I want to check this out before I read her new book. This one sounds really good. It's a thriller. It's about this group of friends. They go on a trip around New Year's every single year. This year, they've gone to the Scottish Highlands, and one of them dies, and one of them killed the other person. So thriller mystery. It sounds really good and I'm excited to read it. Next up, I have a horror book. Now, I don't read a lot of horror, but this book is a Red Riding Hood retelling, so I had to grab it. It's called The Girl in Red by Christina Henry. All I really know is there's like a sickness that took out a whole bunch of the population. And this girl is in a red coat alone in the woods, and it's been described as horror. A few people really loved it last year on BookTube, so I love Red Riding Hood. I love Red Riding Hood retellings. They're some of my favorites, so of course I had to scoop this one up. I also decided to grab quite a popular book, The Hearts of Invisible Furies by John Boyne. Now, all I really know is this is about an adopted boy kind of coming to terms with his life, and I believe it just follows his life. It's one of those slice of life stories, and I think it's set in the 1940s. I've always wanted to pick up this book, so when I saw it on Bookoutlet, I was very happy because it was for a fraction of the regular price. Now, an author I've been really trying to get into this year is Nora Roberts. I'm slowly realizing her books aren't just fluffy romances, so of course I picked up Blood Brothers. This is book one in the Sign of Seven trilogy, and this is about a creepy little town where every 7 years strange things start to happen, and that is because these boys went camping at the pagan stone. So it sounds very vague. The back is very vague. It's one of those books that I think is going to be really good to go in blind to. A creepy little town. Sign me up. This next book is a little bit out of my element. I haven't been reading a lot of YA in the last few years, but I've kind of been more attracted to YA in the last couple months. So I picked up Call It What You Want. This is about Rob and Megan, and they both are having a really tough time. Rob's father was embezzling some money and it kind of put their family in trouble. And then Megan, she's an overachiever and she's trying to uphold her family name because her sister came home from college pregnant and is just trying to be like the good daughter. Rob and Megan get paired together for a calculus project, and Rob decides he's going to fix all of the damage his father did, but it will break apart their friendship and some other things kind of connected to the town, I'm assuming. So it's about these two kids learning basically right from wrong, or standing in the middle of right from wrong. It sounds like a really good heartfelt YA book dealing with some tough topics, and that's the YA I like, so I'm hoping this is a good one. I also picked up a thriller I've had my eye on for a long time, and it's called The Good Son. This is about a young boy in Korea, I believe, and one day he just wakes up to find his mother dead, on the bottom of the stairs in their home, and he suffers from seizures, so he can't really remember what has gone on, but he remembers his mother calling his name at night. So then for a few days he tries to uncover what happened to his mother. This book is translated. I've had it on my radar for quite some time, so when it was on sale on Bookoutlet, I was super excited to add it to my cart. A very beautiful book I picked up is called What We Lose. I just love this cover. It is so gorgeous. This is actually a memoir, which I didn't realize it was. It is about a girl who is half black and half white, and her mother gets cancer, and she has never really learned about her mother's heritage or where she's come from. And it's basically her memoir of learning who she is and struggling with her mother's cancer diagnosis. So it sounds like a really heartfelt book, and I'm hoping to get to it soon. So I also took the opportunity to pick up some summery books, so I'll probably read these next few when the weather gets a little bit warmer, but I have The Forever Summer by Jamie Brenner. Now, this is about a girl named Marion, and Marion has a very well-to-do life in Manhattan, but then she loses her job, and a girl shows up on her door saying, "Hi, I'm your half-sister," and Marion is kind of down on her luck, so she decides to go to Cape Cod to meet the family she's never known. This gives me Ellen Hildebrand vibes, and I need more Ellen Hildebrand vibes in my life and in the summer. So family secrets in like a summery town, sign me the heck up. I cannot wait to sink my teeth into this one. And speaking of summer and Ellen Hildebrand, I of course picked up some Ellen Hildebrand. So I have The Matchmaker, which is about a girl named Dambini. I can't say her name very well. But she's a matchmaker on Nantucket, and she basically matches couples, and they're so happy. And then her old high school boyfriend shows up. There's a tragedy that happens that brings out some family secrets. Sounds like the perfect summer Ellen Hildebrand to me. And then I also picked up Summerland, which I have been wanting to get my hands on this book for so long. It is about these teenagers that are just graduated from high school, and they get into a drunk driving accident, I think, or it's a car accident of some kind. I don't know if it's a drunk driving. And one of them's in a coma, one of them's dead, and two of them is okay. So you have to find out what exactly happened and all that fun stuff. So I'm so excited for summer. I cannot wait to read these. I love Ellen Hildebrand so much. Alright guys, and that is my little Bookoutlet panic buying haul. I feel like there might be more of these depending on how long we're in quarantine for. So I am really excited about these books. I've got some books that I've had my eye on for a really long time, and some kind of newer ones that caught my eye. So please let me know if you've read any of these, what you think of any of them. Please let me know what books you've been panic buying. I'd love to chat to you guys in the comments. Anyways, that's it. That's all. Please remember to like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Happy reading.